Hi, in this video I'm presenting you our work, a new model for visual verb sense disambiguation. If I'm telling you the verb play, this may have potentially different meanings, like engaging in a sport or performing some music. But if I'm pairing the verb with an image, the correct sense straightforwardly emerges, indeed, after having understood what inside of the image. Visual verb sense disambiguation is a new task in the domain of NLP and computer vision. The task is to disambiguate the meaning of a verb paired with an image. Here, different from the standard NLP disambiguation task, we don't have a phrase in which the verb appears, but we have only an image. Hence, the context of the verb is derived by the image itself and its analysis. So, for example, by using object detector and caption generators. This task is very important, in particular in those fields on the intersection between vision and language, such as action recognition, activity detection, and human-robot interaction. So, as you may think, annotating a dataset for this task is particularly expensive, since both non-trivial visual and linguistic skills are needed. So, being a newer task, the related work are quite limited, and there are only two publications facing it. The one proposed in Gall et al., who actually introduces this task and the dataset, and Silber et al. The models in the literature are based on unsupervised or supervised methods trained on multimodal embeddings, relying on inductive paradigms to disambiguate verbs. Being inductive, this means that once the model is learned, the disambiguation operation is performed in isolation for each image-verb pair, neglecting the similarities between the sample and the dataset that might be useful to further disambiguate verbs. Looking at what has been done so far, we found two main issues, though. A high cost when annotating such a dataset, and that the verbs are disambiguated in isolation without taking into account potential similarities with other samples. So to overcome both issues, we thought of using a semi-supervised transductive model. Transductive semi-supervised learning relies on a small set of labeled points, hence reducing the labeling effort, and at the same time they exploit similarities between all the samples, labeled and unlabeled, to get a better prediction. Our disambiguation method is built upon a graph-based transductive semi-supervised model named Graph Transduction Games, which takes as input a probability assignment between nodes and labels, in which in our case are the senses, and pairwise similarities. The process iteratively refines such probabilities considering node similarities until convergence. Provide a dataset of image-verb pairs in which we have a set of labeled green border in the image and unlabeled black border in the image. Our model is divided into four parts. We first extract feature from the chosen modality, which is textual, visual, or multimodal. We then build a graph in which each node is an image-verb pair, and then compute pairwise similarities, the edge weights. Then we initialize the assignment probability between image-verb pair and the senses, provided that certain ones are labeled while others are not. The sense propagation between labeled and unlabeled pair is performed through a dynamical system until convergence. At this point, all the nodes get labeled, hence disambiguated. The experiment has been carried out on the publicly available benchmark for this task, the VERS dataset, and its variant, the VERS 19 verb, on both textual, visual, and multimodal features. Our competitors are the authors of the dataset comprising both supervised and unsupervised baselines. The performances have been assessed considering the sense disambiguation accuracy. Two sets of annotation have been used, the gold one, which were handmade, and the predicted ones generated by software. We've shown that by considering only two labeled samples per sense, we were able to outperform the unsupervised models, while totally crashing the supervised model when the labeled set increases, and this happens in both VERS and VERS 19 datasets. We also report ablation studies to check performances on fine-grained analysis on the number of labeled points, our free parameter. We consider VERS and VERS 19 dataset as well, and in both tests the results were the same. After a couple of points we were able to outperform our supervised model, while after 6 to 8 labeled points we outperform also the fully supervised ones. So concluding, we propose a new model for multimodal visual verb sense disambiguation based on a transductive semi-supervised learning method. The proposed model is general enough to handle both unimodal and multimodal embeddings of image-verb pairs. Two labeled points per sense are sufficient to outperform unsupervised models, while 6 to 8 points are needed for having better performances than fully supervised disambiguation competitors. Here you have the key references for our work, and thanks for your attention, and if you are interested, the code is available at this link.